So this video is just to show the new version of the math formula add-on, which now works with fields. Because the problem was that the previous version was made for Blender 2.93, where there was still the old geometry node system with the attribute nodes, and therefore the add-on only worked partially. So the new it has been sort of redesigned to work better with the field system. And I'll put a link in the description here where you can download this zip file, which contains exactly the add-on, which you can then install the usual way you install add-ons from Blender. So let's go into Blender itself to see how the add-on works. So maybe just to show, once you go to the preferences, I'll search math formula. You have some things you can change here, like the colors, if you have a different theme which doesn't work well with the colors. So, as the name suggests, you need to press Alt-F to enable it. So let's press Alt-F. Currently, let's move to the shading to geometry nodes first. So I'll press Alt-F, and this gives you this prompt where you can start typing a formula. So let's type a very basic formula, like 4 plus 5. And I press Ctrl-Enter to confirm. And it adds exactly 4 plus 5 as an add node. So we can also sort of make, instead of choosing numbers, we can choose variables x and y. And it will just add these as input nodes for the multiplying. Now, if we instead do, for example, the dot product between x and y, then as you can see, it adds vector inputs because these are vector math nodes. So we can create formulas that are a bit more complicated. So let's take, for example, the dot product between x and y, and check if that is less than maybe x times y. Okay, so because these are both vectors, well, this one is a float, but this is a vector, it knows it has to choose the less than mode for vectors. However, this will not work in the shading node base because there's no compare node for vectors. So let's try something else. Maybe x plus y times 10, oops, times 10 minus 0.5. And as you can see, it does it. So maybe as a practical example, let's look at this one here. So this is the SDF4 capsule, and I got this from Inigo Quiles's website. Probably mispronounced that, so let's just get on with it. So as you can see, it has multiple inputs, and with B, A, and B are both all vectors, and R is a float. However, I'm just going to say A is a vector. When the curly braces are just, you can put the inputs to the vector here. So for example, the first component is 1, second is 2, third is 3, but you can also just not input them all and leave them as defaults. And then PA is going to be P minus A. And because it knows that A has to be a vector, this subtract has to be a vector math subtract, and this P is going to be a vector as well. And similarly for BA, is equal to B minus A. All right, so then we can just keep, basically copy exactly the formula. So the dot product BA between BA divided by the dot product, oops, by BA and BA, and close the brackets. And then finally, we can say that, for example, distance is the length of BA minus BA times H minus R. So as you can see, that added the formula. And not only did it add the formula, but it also kept track of the types to ensure that we switch between vector math nodes and just regular math nodes whenever we need them. So, okay, this is a formula, but as you can see, these use, for example, input nodes, which input vector nodes, which are only available for geometry nodes. And if you go to shading, press Alt-F again, and I'm gonna press Ctrl-Up arrow to get the last prompt, and I press Enter. This adds a new line. If I press Ctrl Enter, then it adds the same formula, but this time using shading nodes. and it had to use combine XYZ nodes because, well, there's no vector input node for shaders. So let's try maybe something else. I'm going to show off another feature. So I've pressed Alt F, and let's say we want to get the texture coordinates. So don't worry if you mistype something. So for example, if I do this, and if I try to confirm by pressing Control Enter, it will give me an error. So it's like saying, well, this function texture coord doesn't exist, it's texture coord. Now I can press Alt C to check if there are any errors, and at the bottom here it says no errors detected, so we're good to go. And I want the object coordinates. So once I have these, maybe I want to scale them by 0.5, or maybe scale them by 5, and then we can take the fract of this, and then we subtract 0.5 from it. Take the absolute value, something like this. And now maybe, because these are all vectors, let's take the x and y components. So I mean, these could just be any names. So for example, you could call this A, B. And I'm just, by ignoring the third component, it just, nothing just gets set to this. So let's set these to x and y. And as you can see, well, it got these x and y. I accidentally pressed Control Enter. So let me get back my prompt, pressing Enter. And maybe you want to, for example, take the smooth minimum of x and y. And then check if this is less than 0.2. So there we go. As you can see, that works exactly as you'd want. Now, using Node Wrangler, I can preview this. Let's see if there's a plane. Let's give it our material. Well, looks like Blender is being very slow right now. Maybe it's just my computer. And there we go. So as you can see, if I change the distance input, we can change the smoothness. But this is not a tutorial about shader nodes, so I'm just going to stop here. And if you have any feedback, you can put them in the comments of the YouTube video, or create an issue here. So thanks for listening, and hope you have fun with this add-on.